Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you how to use filters that use multiple columns. Let's take a look at the measure I wrote here. It has calculate sales amount, where product brand equals contoso and product color equals green. Because I used two filters in calculate, they are placed in a logical AND, they are intersected. Therefore, the number that I see here is the value of sales, which are green and contoso. What if I want to do an OR condition? For whatever reason, I want to see the sales, which are contoso or green. I cannot use multiple conditions in calculate, because by default they are placed in AND. So I might want to use an OR condition. I can add an OR operator. But this is not going to work. If I hit enter, you see that I obtain an error. The error says that the expression contains multiple columns, but only a single column can be used in a true-false expression inside calculate. What's the meaning of that? I have used the compact syntax of calculate that allows that will be transformed into a table. But I'm using two columns, so the engine does not know if it needs to do all brand or all color. Using the compact syntax, I cannot use more than one column. But I can go for the extended syntax and write a filter over all product, where product brand equals contoso or product color equals green. This seems to work, and indeed, it will work and produce the expected result here. But it has a very big problem. Using all product, I'm replacing the filter not only on the brand or color columns. I'm removing any filter from the product table and replacing it with a filter over brand and color. Therefore, it is likely not to work in a different report. Remember, you always need to work with the minimum number of columns which are required for your goal. Indeed, in our case, we only need the brand and the color, so filtering all product is just too strong. We need to build a table that only contains brand and color and remove filters from only these two columns. We have the all function that does it. Instead of doing all product, we can do all product brand, product color. This version of the code is much safer because we touch two columns and we use only these two columns. The result is not going to change here, but this measure used in different report will behave much better. You see that if I use filter all brand color, this way I obtain the desired result. Now, this syntax replaces the filter on two columns, but because I had to use all, it will overwrite, it will ignore outer filters and replace them with the current filter. What if the user applies a filter on the color? For example, applies a filter on gold or green. You see that the number does not change because the filter on gold and green is always replaced by my filter. If I want not to ignore the filter, but I want to fill the outer filter and add the filter for contoso and brand, then I can mix a table filter, a table with two column filter, with keep filters. So I can change my measure and add keep filters around it. Writing it in this way, now I have a different semantics. This is building a table with all the brands and color, filtering only contoso and green, so all the brands and colors where the brand is contoso or the color is green, but this filter will not replace the outer filter. It will be put side by side with the outer filter, so the outer filter will be kept and this will be added as a further filter. You see that once you learn that filters of calculate are tables, you can start to build more complex tables and always obtain the goal that you need. Enjoy DAX!